Dire team ban. TNC's turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. Dire team ban. TNC's turn to ban. Dire team pick.
Earth spirit.
TNC's turn to pick.
Weaver.
TNC's turn to pick.
Vengeful spirit.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Rubik.
TNC's turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. TNC's turn to ban. Dire team ban.
I mean, you can never rule out a team like TNC. There's always that possibility, for sure, but I mean, I strongly feel like... Well, I'm just going to say that. I'm going to stick to my prediction. I'm going to say that 2-1 is the best case scenario. And...
Reserve time.
Just hope that the spirits aren't broken. That they're... adjustments, and you know, adjustments for ice hero bans.
TNC's turn to pick. Dire team pick.
Earth Spirit Rubik as the first two heroes. I think XY and Nuts both having extremely good success with the heroes, right?
Ten seconds remaining.
Five. It's on the other team. Remaining.
Reserve time.
TNC taking bits and pieces from last draft. Venge and Ogre Magi. Is there going to be any chance that this is going to be a core Venge as well? think I'm going to agree with you there. I'm pretty sure that is going to be that sacrificial venge that we always see from Rior. I think Faceless are probably not going to let their lanes do so poorly this time around. If there's like one adjustment I would make with the Faceless draft is that they need to ensure that their laning phase like doesn't go like that again. But I don't think you ever plan for your laning phase to go that badly and then win from the middle game onwards.
Meek's assassin.
TNC's turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I mean, it definitely goes hand in hand, but it's all last game.
Reserve time.
Ogre wasn't there to the lanes. It was just the lane was just gonna feed. TA versus sniper. Sniper with the shrapnel just made it pretty much impossible for the TA to approach the lane, especially with Tim's nice. Decaying nonstop.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Yeah, definitely. Seems like it's not going to happen this game either. Remaining. Unless, for some odd reason, like, Weaver's mid and they pick up another support.
Reserved.
Imba spirit.
TNC's turn to ban.
I mean, it's definitely a thing, but it's not exactly like as you mentioned, pretty much winning the game for them, right? Ogre Axe isn't quite the same as Darkseer Slardar in a team fight.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Klinks is actually pretty good here. I think right. And the rest of the team has a lot of lockdown for definitely viable here. I think the most important thing here is to make sure Jabs actually has a good start this time instead of like last game. Especially because he's playing Ember and there's an Ogre on the other side.
Dire team.
They pan out Wraith King. Watching yesterday's games. I don't think Wraith King is a pick here, though.
Ten seconds remaining.
That was the last game. Game, it was strong because
5 seconds
they had Bloodlust and Empower. This game is neither.
Dire team pick.
Something interesting to note, SD and Luna both completely ignored.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds.
And Lone Druid is out as well.
Reserve time.
What a strange time for a patch. I was just like wondering to myself, why did you patch it? Like in the middle of a fairly large tournament qualifying? But like, qualifiers are only going to be a couple more days. Like they could have waited on it and then released the patch after the qualifiers.
10 seconds remaining.
So that everyone is on like open grounds. Called it the Clinks.
TNC's turn to pick.
I agree with you. Wraith King would have been good here at all. If we follow the patterns of
10 seconds remaining.
TNC drafting style versus this Faceless team. They just want to draft something that can beat Ember Spirit in a lane. And there is still a quap.
Reserve time.
Yeah. Oh, what is this? I have seen some teams run this. I don't remember which ones. I remember seeing it, though. It's not bad. I would have to check the change logs to see just exactly how he was buff. I just know that Troll Warlord definitely was buff. Also, this recent patch, it's a very small change. His talents are very slightly buff. Level 10, he gets 7 strength instead of 6. Level 20, he gets 350 health instead of 300. So, as far as 7.02 goes, nothing really changed about Troll Warlord.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
And see exactly what it is. Like, does anything really stand out to you? Something like OP?
Level 25 whirling death, or whirling axes.
Yeah, I...
Like perma blind.
Alright, this Venge Taunt is not it.
See it. Ah, this looks not bad.
I don't know. This looks just silly.
It's annoying. Well, I mean, that's the point. Level 1 smoke. Gonna be completely dodged here. TNC gonna dodge this safe lane again. Expecting Faceless to aggro tri-lane? Or no, actually no, they just want to fight with they just want to fight tri-lane versus tri-lane.
Yeah. I don't think they're dodging, they want to take
the fight to them. Yeah, they're not dodging, my bad.
And of course, I think Klinks is actually pretty bad against tri-lane setups, because Klinks is okay, like, once he gets to, like, level 3. But the first couple levels is suffering for him. But this time around, Faceless is gonna get the dodge off themselves. And this is ultimately going to be a very good lane setup, in my opinion, for Team Faceless.
Yeah. This is going to be up to TNC to rotations if necessary, and I think they might have to fairly soon. I'm just curious as to how they run this Troll Warlord.
Yeah, that is the thing that we're all looking for, right? The lane, I think it's gonna do quite okay against Japs, if you ask me.
So too. He has to be. It's still like not the greatest of matchups, I guess, because he doesn't really have a reliable way of break guard. So if he's mispositioned, like even once, could be in danger. So you have to be careful with that.
No, if you see Ember going on you, just cast your bash and then walk it off.
Oh, okay. That blind chance as well.
Top lane, looks like Swarm has flown off here against Ice. Taking quite a bit of right click damage, but should be okay. He's got the high regen.
Two Venge mangoes.
Samage trying to farm under his tower, but Black's gonna make him struggle a little bit. Now the pulling's gonna start. Although I think against Axe, he's probably one of the heroes that don't care about pulls all that much.
See if that's gonna snipe this zap. Mm-hmm. Why? Oh, why actually died?
I'm never looking at top lane again, because that Venge is taunting nonstop.
Yeah, that's why it's a good taunt, it's tilting. Like, you're not even in the game and you're tilted.
Yeah, I guess so. But as a player, I don't want to use that taunt, because it's tilting me too, if I was Venge. That should help.
Spirit has a smoke. Are they going to make a rotation here?
Yes, they are. They are going to at least smoke up there. Whether they go bot or mid is a different story. It looks like they're going to circle around and backstab the Troll Warlord. Here's the thing about ganking Troll.
I don't know, like Whirling Axe.
Okay. I think this makes a little bit more sense. I think Troll is actually deceptively hard to gank because of Whirling Axes. Smoke's going to break. And Sandmage.
Where's their...
Okay, Berserker's Call getting him a little bit of armor. Sandmage thinks he's gonna... Oh, that creep though, blocking him, and now he's completely trapped black. Gonna take the first blood.
That was a very impressive block.
Yeah,
that by his own creeps. Nuts, or was that his own creep?
Yeah, that is just his own creep. I honestly think if he Berserker's Call and ran straight to the tower, he probably was safe.
Safe, but nice gank anyways. I have to admit, I did not expect for that to get as well as it did for them.
Mid lane rolling in. XY's gonna get the kickoff, and now Jab's coming in. The chain's gonna hit, and he needs to pop that Whirling Axe. His magic missile's gonna hit. He's gonna commit for the kill. He pops the Fairy Fire. We'll get the kill in Cuckoo. With the place. Jab's did not have the fire? Or... Oh, the Whirling Axe just took it out because it's only level 1.
It's only level 1, yeah.
Yeah. I find that super surprising.
Right as I mentioned, you know, Flame Guard being difficult to take out, he doesn't level it. Because I genuinely believe that there's pretty much no way you can get rid of it. Like, Black has made the rotation top.
Well, he's just following Sandmage. Sandmage TP'd up top, shield himself. And then he's like, no, we still won that lane matchup, so they follow him.
Teams just completely switch their lanes.
I think they're trying to bait out Ice to use the spike. But he ain't about that life. Oh, Pale's gonna come through again. Here comes Tim wrapping around. Okay, they bait out the spike. Magic missile right on time, but it's lifted towards the tower and Tim's it will taunt as he runs them off.
Ice, the taste of donut medicine.
Seems like once again, Jabs is losing the lanes. Signed by a pretty wide margin as well. It's down about 700 gold.
Like you said, right? Troll probably not gonna have a hard time against this. In this matchup, at least. And
I mean, I didn't think it was that bad, right?
I think it's like actually pretty bad. Most range heroes just seem to do pretty decently against Ember Spear, as long as they don't get caught out.
Yeah, I haven't seen Troll too much, so I don't really know the full extent of his power. But one would assume Ember would do okay, but apparently not. It's also, you know, getting ganked sometimes.
Well, Ice is about to hit 6, and... Trying to think, like, maybe he should gank for his middle lane. I mentioned it before, like, Gabs is really, really strong in the mid game if they actually give him a good start. And past few games, like, they just never give him a good start. He always has a rough lane, a rough matchup. Pretty much gets no help at all.
Yeah, they used to rotate 2 to 3 heroes to his lane just to zone people out, but. Seems like the agenda has changed a little bit.
Tyus is gonna keep farming. Ports, they need their levels right now. P mid. Jab's getting threatened by Cuckoo again. Cuckoo is just bullying him. Crazy.
I think this early game once again favors TNC, but maybe not that big of a margin. Obviously, Black is doing very well, as he generally always do in the lanes. And Ice is getting a lot. I am just worried about the Ember mid. And I feel like this lineup, a lot of it is up to the Ember, right? Yeah, Black's gonna hunt around and look for solo kills, and same thing with Nyx, but at the end of the day, in an actual team fight, I think the majority of the damage has to be dealt out by Jabs.
Well, to be fair, they do have the Earth Spirit at least. Earth Spirit, I think, is actually one of the supports that actually does a fair amount of damage. See, that's true. Gets that level 6. And we have discussed it before. Ember Spirit, you know, even though his laning phase isn't like the greatest, as long as he gets his levels up, they can always put him in a position. Oh, top lane, XY.
Yep.
Done. He's gonna go.
Black gonna go for a kill, but they do have taunt, and that might be a secondary dunk. TNC. Ooh, Tim's might die, and that death pack in the middle of the fight, very crucial. In fact, he might turn it around against SamH. SamH is gonna turn around and try to run, but there's no running from this one.
Oh, that was an excellent play from Black.
Yep.
Using that dark pack.
Exactly. They were gonna get the kill on Black, and Black just juked them in the middle of the fight.
Bottom jabs makes that rotation.
Yep.
I did not even on the support.
Commit any remnants, so we will have more available.
Got that arcane rune going on as well. Want to find as many kills as you can with it. Backing off, playing it very safe right now. Nyx is not gonna find him. But overall, you said TNC might have been winning the lane slightly. I think EXP and net worth wise, Faceless were actually farming a little more efficient than they were. Like that Ice was just getting everything he wanted in the offlane.
Yep, more than he should have. Oh, they actually lift him up despite through the Sakushi. Impaled will miss. And now here comes Black, the right clicks are coming through. They're not going to be enough to actually force any kills. The first gank here by Faceless outside the laning stage, not coming to fruition.
Yeah, just a slight miscommunication. They had the right idea, but unable to connect that pain stun.
What do you think Troll's major item is going to be? Looks like he's going to start things off with the Helm of the Dominator.
Surprised about that. I want the Dominator into Manta, maybe? Or maybe something even more aggressive, like Shadow Blade even?
Two-man silence, two-man kick, Black backstabbing in the top lane here. That's gonna be one kill, jab porting in. That's gonna be a secondary one. Black is dominating.
Never refuse gold. Very interesting build as well. He actually opts to max Windwalk first, makes him that much more mobile. Yeah. Pressures the entire map like way better.
Yeah, this is not the first time he's done this. It feels like this is his build. He does
this. This is his build, yeah.
Yeah, every single time he does not max Searing Arrows. Which, yeah, I mean, I guess it gets you the fights very frequently, and honestly, if you're smart about taking fights, I don't think you really need the 4th point of the arrow, right? Like, in that particular scenario just now, the difference between the 3rd and 4th point of arrow was negligent. It's mostly XY hitting a 2-man slam on 2-man stun. And him
the
being
triple
there.
Remnant.
Yeah.
Alright, tables have turned this game. Faceless are leading the early game, not as crazily as last game, TNC lead, but they are leading this time. See how they manage the mid game. I'm pretty sure, like, this is kind of going back to their standard way of playing from what I've seen.
Mm-hmm.
And they pressure the map with the clinks, and it pretty much allows like, everyone to get a
ton of
farm.
the swap was good, but the silence was much, much better by XY. Tims cannot get off his magic missile. It looks like the Magnetize will take down one kill. Tims gonna try to run away, but Magnetize still on him, and looks like he is getting scouted constantly by Nuts. Sentry's gonna get dropped on the back by Nuts with the explosive kill. He's now Sakushing away. That Sentry were not granting him the vision. That's also a tower kill. Jabs, despite not doing so well in the lanes, kills his way up to a Veil. And is looking to set up a kill here on the bottom side against Raven.
Ice.
Triple Remnant.
That is some extreme confidence in your teammate.
Yep.
Not even confirming whether or not the stun has landed. He just believed.
Well, I think regardless of whether the stun has landed or not, like that was the only one opportunity you had there, right? So, because once he sees the Ember in the lane, there's no way he'll stay around. But yeah, fortunately Ice has missed. And like you said, maybe Nyx is just a bad hero. Everyone's just missing stuns on him.
Not easy. But at the end of the day, it's still like an incredibly good hero against Weaver. Maybe he should have been a little more patient, try to bait out the Shukuchi and anticipate Carapace.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Mid lane Black.
Mid lane.
Circling in, XY coming in with the stun and the right clicks. Even the tanky ogre is gonna have a tough time here. Jabs will pick up the kill. And Faceless
still has that. Still has that regen running. Full health again.
Good efficiency.
And I still have not really seen this troll warlord being put to use. Farming away.
Hidden creeps, man. That's the best use of Troll Warlord. In creeps till you lose.
Oh, mid lane? Silence?
Row in? Okay. They net him up. I don't know if they want to fight this. Man, that Magnetize is scaring them away.
Oh, Raven? Going in. No more rocks on XY too.
XY? Very, very low. Raven gets netted. Oh. Nicely done. That chain, and of course they take down the Venge alongside him as well. Rior's gonna try to run away, but the right click, the bugs being stolen by Nuts, doing so much work. Impale, that's gonna hit.
Got him.
That's gonna be a kill. The entire team of Faceless just swarming over them.
That was so depressing for Raven. One hit away from the guard and I think it's an auto attack cancelled by the Searing Chain.
I don't want to be a negative Nancy, but I think you might be right with that 2-0 prediction. Because this is... Unless we're going to see a rampage by this Troll Warlord or something, you know?
I don't know if we're going to see that.
Alright,
here we go. This is the... I would Here's consider this a desperation smoke. Oh, they're just going straight into Roku.
Yeah. I like this. I feel like going for a gank has a much lower success rate. And would look at Cuckoo go, my god. Rip Roche.
They ping it out. Even with the Aegis, they can still take the steam fight. TNC have to get the hell out of here.
Yeah, TNC is just looking to get an objective and fall back. I don't think I've ever seen Sandmage struggle so hard in the early game. Like, normally he has blink and like two kills with the blink by now. But speaking of that blink, it's flying out now. Maybe with another smoke gank, now with the Aegis, with Sandmage initiating, maybe they stand a much better chance.
I just kind of worry about their... Well, actually, you know, even though they're behind by this much, I think they still definitely have the damage output. It's just that Faceless have so much CC. Kind of control up the team fights. It's always difficult to just focus down anyone.
Yep. It feels it's so easy for Faceless to take a team fight because once XY rolls in, his teammates are so mobile. They come in from all angles. Whereas, I feel like the same is not true for TNC. Venge, Ogre, these are very slow. Sandmage jumps, and it's gonna be a quick kill on XY. They ganked a four position support, so.
Gonna be an easy tier one. Faces look like they're grouping up this defense. Black has the damage right now. He's got Desolator running already.
Alright, Swarm's gonna fly out. They saw Ice going in Viz, I assume. Under the ward, but nothing much they could do about it.
This guy's off to a great start, actually. Got Midas already. Damn, he's freaking farmed for a Nyx. He's been farming like crazy, actually.
He's keeping up with the Weaver.
Yeah.
Weaver is the carry here. And I've been seeing this build endlessly, like the Weaver getting the casual Perseverance. And then now looks like he's going to go back for a Power Triss.
Oh, interesting.
Maybe that previous team fight where he missed that one auto attack is like, god damn it. If I had them Tretts.
That would be a very poor reason to purchase Treads.
No, that's his thing. He's one of the few Weaver players that does not skip boots and its upgrade. Maybe TNC just have a thing with Treads. Remember last game, Sam H getting Treads on the Nyx Assassin?
True. Alright, Nyx. That's a Blink Dagger now. Use a smoke on their own.
I mean, you Blink Spike Impale, right, on top of Raven. There's no escape from him. Alright, just... Nice defensive fall by Tims, but the right click. Black says, sure, I'll take this one, no problem. Alright, teleport in, nothing. All trouble, but he has the Kushi's out, and on the backside here, Black, again, up to his backstabbing. And they actually get off the call. Here. Blink Impale only gets Sam H, but they're gonna follow up. XY's gonna come in. That Magnetize on four with the Veil, but pretty good stun turning him back here. It's gonna be Troll Warlord going down. He still has the Aegis. Raven
drops. Raven low. Goes down.
He's gonna
as well.
Go down to a zap, and now Cuckoo respawns, but they're gonna follow him up. Great Impale by Ice. Courier is gonna get one-shotted by Black. He pops a BKB, but he will die here, I think. Black looking for the right click. Moving forward, thanks to that movement speed, they dust him to slow him down. Cuckoo will make it up to the hills. TNC will sacrifice himself once again. That was, I believe, a 6-for-1. They took the Aegis, they took Venge
five
twice.
For one.
Venge died twice.
Oh, Venge died twice, you're right.
Yeah. They need to have like two. Oh, he also bought back apparently in that fight.
Rip.
And they lost
and
a courier.
That was... Lost a courier? 10 second BKB?
Yep.
Damn, things are not going well for TNC.
I don't know. I don't see what they could do to make a comeback. That was it, right? That was everything.
That was everything, yeah. Oh man, and is Cuckoo gonna die again? He's getting followed by Black.
Yeah, he doesn't have to be KB.
He's gonna die here again.
Oh.
Oh,
Ice. Take that bounty rune in front of him. He does.
And this was... Listen, we were used to seeing in the qualifiers.
Yep. Now there's a gem on XY. Gonna shut down the vision. It's a death choke, man. You do not get out of it.
Yeah, this is looking so bad for TNC right now. Like, look at the support. Both of these faceless supports, at least.
Oh my goodness.
Actually, they both have more than the two supports on TNC combined.
Yep.
Very bad sign.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Oh, and Black is going for that sheepstick as the next item.
Damn, man. I'm so used to seeing Black going like second item BKB in closer games just because he wants to be a little bit more defensive to maintain his damage output. But that is not of concern right now. Alright, TNC, probably with a Desperation Smoke coming out. Smoke is gonna break. Link called a Dupont jab. Silence gonna be only on one. They're gonna try to burst him down. They need a dump, but because he's silenced, no. Does not make it away. And now they're gonna chase on XY. XY's rotate away. And Raven does not block the row. So one is all they're gonna get. No! Two man call. Nicely done. The Impale's gonna be there to have enough damage output. They activate the Shrine and they keep alive Black. No, Cuckoo's damage output a little bit too much. Now he's gonna go on XY. And XY rotates again.
Wait, the Weaver?
Blast of the bug. Gets him. He's dead. Now,
Nuts gonna go
away.
Down too.
Yeah, he does not steal the Sakuchi. Only got swarmed back. Okay.
Alright, we spoke too soon.
Did get the gem though. That looks like the gem was rescued by the courier. Yes. Okay.
So I guess that's the strength of a troll warlord. Even though you're so far behind, yeah, you still have a lot of damage just because everyone attacks at like max speed almost. Or maybe not that much. 20 attack speed. Joke.
I mean, I guess one part of the downside of all the wards that the Faceless team got, you see wards like everywhere in front of the base, right? They have no wards in their own jungle, and that smoke definitely caught them out.
I think the biggest thing about that team fight was just because our spirit pretty much used everything just to save Jabs and didn't even manage to save him, and Jabs wasn't able to do anything that fight.
Right. And then the team decided to come back and fight despite losing essentially the Earth Spirit and the Ember Spirit, because like you said, a lot of Earth Spirit stuff was on cooldown. So perhaps that was a poor choice for Faceless to take that fight. It was right on top of Shrine, but Sam H.
Yeah, that double call sealed the deal. That was a great call from him.
And that's pretty much what Cuckoo wants, right? Just freely to stack his fervor and right-click with his battle trance. Fervor and battle trance are the two skill names I didn't think I need to say today.
And I think with that team fight, he might have to reconsider his sheepstick purchase. Yeah, he's got something queued up already.
Yeah, I think this is probably the same trick. Oh, swaps it again. It was Ayaskadi, now it's Bloodthorn. Okay. Sure. I think any item that he gets that adds more damage and gives him a little more HP is fine. I'm a bigger fan of the Scotty, but Bloodthorn is also quite good.
Yeah, I think so too. Great for that Weaver. And, well, Bloodthorn is just OP in general. If you manage to get it, like, that item is just insane.
Yeah, I mean, you say it's great for the Weaver because of the silence. I'm more thinking of, like, you just show people. Like, yeah, you put it on Trove. Doesn't matter if you silence him or not, he just dies.
It did get nerfed, though.
What was the nerf on it?
They raised the cooldown.
Okay. I think that's actually fair, because that cooldown was a bit ridiculous.
Size? Oh, he's already spent it. He's just gonna go for the Yule Scepter first. I actually still think that Black should probably go for something that allows him to tank up, but to be fair, even with that kind of a team fight going in for TNC, they're still gonna need like way more than that. I think like that kind of opportunity is not gonna come again.
Yeah, I mean, I think if they win another big team fight, like 4-0 in lane, Rior's gonna get picked up, gets kicked. Oh no, Rior. Dies. Oh, Venge gets caught. Tim's rooted out. Do they have more? Oh, the right clicks. Something silence. That's why he's gonna roll back out. Despite him having a gem, he plays super aggressively, and now they kick him up. Cuckoo stunned up. Man, Cuckoo not afraid because he has the BKB, so he's chasing very aggressively. They see Black.
All right, Black is committed to the Bloodthorn now. Looks like Faceless are just gonna... The lane's pushed out, make use of these base wards. These wards are only gonna work if they manage to keep all the creep waves in front of their base right now. The creep wave up top needs to be handled.
Yeah, otherwise you're seeing a lot of vision, but they're not of much use for you. I think if Faceless loses another fight and they lose a gem on top of maybe like a tier 2, I think TNC has a shot.
Yeah, definitely. But... Oh, mid lane. Is Rior gonna get caught again? Close enough. Nice size. He has a Ghost Scepter queued up. I wonder if he is gonna go for that Ethereal Blade. I don't want to see it. I think it's actually legit. 40 agility is pretty insane. And having extra armor once again, like, really good this game.
I mean, I think he's just getting a Ghost Scepter so he doesn't die to
Troll. Yeah.
The Troll.
And but, Weaver.
Yeah, if the game goes long and he could upgrade it, he probably will.
Three.
Cuckoo. Impale up. They have to swap here, but the play by Ice impales one, yules another. So there's going to be no save. Tim's going to get caught out here as well. Well, that double kill, I think they're going to just go into the high ground. What a play by Ice.
That was an understanding of what's meant to happen. Because it's very similar to that Wisp Power gameplay, you know? You have your carry push out and farm, but you always have them protected by... In this case, it's a swap. He identifies exactly where the bench is. See, double kill. Sean is up. Sean for Faceless this time.
Alright, Black. We'll lead the team into the pit. Oh, it looks like he's not looking to finish his Bloodthorn. So he wants to upgrade to a Hurricane Pike.
I think that's fair. He helps against Troll Warlord. You don't want him to be meleeing you.
I guess the game plan right now for Faceless is to... All they have to do is tie out that BKB. If they survive the BKB, they're fine.
BKB is still at 8 seconds. Who is still a very big threat to them. The only problem is, like, the rest of his team just doesn't really farm. Apart from the Weaver, but kind of like expected.
Yeah, but the Weaver, despite his farm, is like not doing that much damage.
Yeah, I guess he's hitting... very defensive.
He is hitting for 200 damage, but I just don't know 200 damage right now is not enough.
Radiant's top tower. He has the Aura and Bloodlust and Troll Warlord ulti. Maybe so bad. Radiant's top tower has fallen. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. You might see a team fight down here. He's gonna play it safe. Push their luck. Now that Faceless have all these lanes pushed up pretty far, all the wards run out.
It's okay, they could put up another set of them. Do they still have that gem? XY has it. I guess he needs to kind of rotate through the map and start clearing them again.
Imba strength now. As well. War staff is going to be like the most important item for pretty much everyone on Faceless. This helps so much with dealing with a Troll Warlord.
Oh, Black breaks the smoke and now runs away. They don't have the catch. Damage was a little bit lagging behind, and that's unfortunate.
Well, once again, this game is like very, very much on Sam H, because with the blade mail, he can handle this Klinks.
Yeah, especially if he catches him with Strafe activated.
Yeah, but he has to wait out the Aegis. Like, you can't just fight up against the Aegis because you're just going to throw away your life for an Aegis, and I don't think he has enough for buyback.
Yeah, he's very far off. He's trying to get that BKB, I imagine.
Faceless. Still playing it pretty slow. Farming the map up. Oh. Go on.
The vision advantage is going to be on this side. No, the two-man stun here by Ice. Two-man chain, they jump forward.
Oh, it's nice. Not over yet.
Blink stun, impale, or Yules picks up Raven on the back line. Looks like they lost the Rubick, but that's pretty much all they lost. Cuckoo did not commit his BKB for that. He does have a Shadow Blade. 2-4 in exchange.
Not too bad. Wait, he's gonna find Cuckoo. Done yet.
Do they have detection? It's a question. They have it, but...
Wait, they can run into Tim's first, I believe.
Okay, Tim's is gonna get a TP cancel. He dies now. Now, if Cuckoo tries to TP away, he's gonna get caught. Although, Ice does not have vision. Oh, Ice with the game got him. Just follows him. He has the BKB, but...
Oh, he has to get out of this. If he's gonna BKB for this, he has to get out. I don't think he's gonna get out.
He has Yules. Yeah, he's dead.
Very nice stun from XY.
Bottom lane. Weaver trying to escape. Does have a Lincoln. Does Black have a way to break the Lincolns? Yes, that's what the Hurricane Pike is for. If they can find him.
Alright, Raven jukes him. Very small break for them. What a disastrous teamfight. Originally, I think getting away with just killing the Rubick was not too bad. But great play from Ice Science just following them. Two more extra kills.
Yep. Man, Ice next play is ridiculous.
Oh, he got the E-Blade and the 40 Agi.
Alright. Can we hover over this E-Blade and it'll tell you how much damage it'll do? Is that something we could do in this game?
It's just 2x plus 75, so it's not that hard to do. I mean, it's 144, or 145.
So...
Well, 290 plus 75. 365.
Okay. That's actually not very much.
Yeah, it's not bad.
An extra nuke.
Well, but you have to remember, right? It applies Ethereal, so it empowers the rest of his abilities. And having a level 4 mana burn, 5 times intelligence, is actually pretty strong. No matter who it is, even if something
runs in.
Alright, this might be.
I mean, it's very good against Cuckoo as well. Like, defensive shotgun, offensive shotgun. Tim's is in there and he's found. He's gonna try to TP out, but Yules? No, Impale's good enough. Tim's gonna get. Nobody
Jazz
wants
is
it.
Jazz is just farming.
Okay. The shotgun won't take it then.
Alright, now he just needs a scepter and then he's really a turret. The ultimate turret, too.
Oh, the silence! So no dunk. Now Black will escape. Man. Damage is just a little bit too slow on that reaction then. The Orchid did pop on him.
Faceless are feeling confident in high ground now? Seems kind of strange considering they just ran out on the Aegis.
Maybe they want to pressure the lane across to drop more base wards.
Are we gonna see like a super safe play from Faceless now and just wait for another agent?
They can. They have all the time in the world, man. TNC is just not farming anything. Whereas Faceless is farming the whole map.
It's like Ice not gonna go for the Scepter build. He's actually gonna go for Shiva's next.
Interesting. I guess Scepter is better for when you're sieging, or defending, excuse me. When you're sieging, I don't think Scepter is at its best.
So much fun, having Scepter and Aether Lens. Your spells go out so far.
Yeah, they probably don't even see you, especially at nighttime. You just get impaled and mana burn.
They're just staying outside their base, not letting them farm at all. So at the rate this game is gonna go, we're just gonna see them sitting outside of their base. TNC are only gonna farm the creeps that are coming into the base and wait for Roshan, it seems.
Yep, constantly taking neutrals from the TNC side of the map.
Jabs has finished his Octarine. Going for the Mjolnir, fairly standard. Yeah. I'm just trying to wonder, or trying to think how he can actually win like an upcoming team fight. I think it still holds true that Sam H is just gonna have to call, like make the hugest calls, otherwise he's not gonna win.
Well, Sam H is kind of that kind of player to make them big plays. So let's keep an eye on him.
Ice knows if he breaks the smoke, like, bad.
Oh, they're pinging him out, and now XY thinks he's actually rotating in. Right into a swap, into a call, and is that the gem? Yes. X takes the XY gem. So, D-Void maybe gets some map control back. That gem also very critical against Ice as well as Black.
That was a very lucky break for TNC. Yep. Of all players to find, they find the one with the gem.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
If you look at their vision, there's really no way they can know where anyone is.
True.
Obviously, this vision just placed now, but before that, they have to blindly walk into enemy territory. Again, that small amount of victory, I guess they feel a little safer trying to deward. But they're still going to be somewhat stuck base. Okay. Fly is back now. Jabs blinks in aggressively.
Okay. Lior. Team's coming in right now. Blink lift to start things off. Another remnant to drop. He's going to go right in. Rior is going to be dead. And now chasing forward. Sam H is caught
this
as well.
This is the important target. Be...
Alright. I think the shotgun was meant for the axe though. So they missed a little bit. Nice defensive swap here. They're still chasing Sam H. They don't care about anybody
else. Sam H.
Yeah, they do get
Sam
H.
They got the gem back.
Raven. Gonna get forced back into his base. To pop that shrine triple remnant in.
That was so close.
Yo,
oh, wait, it's not over yet.
It's not, and they do get him. I mean, they have multiple buybacks. I need to pop it right now. Cuckoo, of course, they do see him. So he, the element of surprise.
No creeps.
Is not, yeah. No, pro- no creeps.
The damage
no
is
problem.
Enough.
Yeah, look at this right click. Wait, cliff.
Radiant's top tower is under
attack. Oh, siege. But they have all the time in the world.
Yeah, nobody's defending versus them.
Radiant's top barracks are under attack. Radiant's top barracks has fallen.
Ben Rubik wishes he stole Bloodlust.
Battle Trance? Oh, okay.
Or Battle Trance too, yeah, even better.
You're thinking about the small efficiency, or I'm thinking about the big one.
Go for my
armor.
Just like that, one lane, one shrine, and Roshan is back. Just on time, and this one is a cheese. Faceless get this, this is probably going to be the end of the game. Although to be fair, I think the game is...
Yeah, one could say that the game has already...
Pretty over, yeah. Black has that butterfly now as well. Damn, this is very scary clean.
I wonder why more teams don't ban Clinks versus Black. They're banning his Pudge instead, but this is...
Because they're too busy banning out Ice this year.
True.
Four of them were all Ice here, and Faceless still didn't go for the Pudge. Alright, this might be it. Wait, Ice has enough for Shiva's. Goes and buys that now.
No Dagon?
I think so.
Well, it's not buying them pieces yet. I guess saving buyback's more important.
Walking back. Oh. Disassembled his mono.
Going for...
He's going for Octarine.
Okay.
Hey, I like this choice too. Alright, the final hold from TNC. Can they do it? Can Sam H delay this game for them?
Link Root on Raven. He's being right clicked on. Look at the damage. Gonna force him to time lapse. Blink call. Blink's defensive shotgun gets used immediately. Blink impale, that's gonna be on two. Triple remnant in to swap back in, but the two supports will die pretty much immediately. Cuckoo joins the fray, but can't really fight. But right clicks will force back Faceless momentarily. But with two supports dead, I think Faceless happy to keep on pushing.
The important target is still alive. Damage.
Link call on the back line. It's going to find the Rubick, but Rubick's not going to be enough. In fact, Rubick's going to heal himself in the air. They really want the Rubick. Rubick will finally go down black. Not going to get bash or anything. In fact, he evades one or two, a couple little hits. It's going to be fine. Axe buybacks. Worm's going to fly out. Oh, nice blink blocker by Sam H. Impale's going to be a follow-up here by Ice Ice Ice. Defensive shotgun coming up from Ice 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 as well. On the back line, though, Cuckoo gets one kill on Clink. But he's going to respawn with the Aegis and Japs just remnanting forward. Not going to find the kill because, well, Raven moved up. Black just laying in into the Raxus. Two Raxus down. Now swinging to the mid lane.
Oh, they caught up Japs. Can they get him?
Looks like they will be able to. Oh, it's so close.
Okay. Ice 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 gets a one counter kill before going on the way out, but looks like he will die here as well.
Bugs on him.
Wait. Wait. He's not dead. Jabs came in, buyback from Raven. He buys back time lapse, but that means he has no time lapse. The shotgun's not going to miss him. Oh my god, the right clicks. This is all of the buyback. Everything being used to hold him.
It's also a mega creep.
Yeah.
Call it. Not the worst to hold. It's actually more impressive than I thought it would be. Because Troll Warlord's damage is no joke. Fatalist.
Well, Faceless did super well in the lane. Well, not super well, but they did good enough. Ice 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 got very rich. Black did extremely well. And once the mid game rolled around, Faceless just did what they normally did. Unfortunately for TNC, they